First, I want to announce a program change. I'm obviously not Stephen Spears, and I will not be singing for you. Stephen is unfortunately ill this morning and cannot sing today, so we'll postpone that performance. I did want to say a few words about the Liszt. It's such a big piece that a few words of introduction might help orient especially first-time listeners. It seems like Franz Liszt, who was a virtuoso pianist, composer, conductor, and influencer, to use that 21st century term, in the 19th century, wrote this sonata, his one and only sonata, kind of in secret. Over 4 or 5 year period, he had retired from the concert stage and was not concertizing anymore, but he was conducting and writing a lot of music. And somewhat uncharacteristically for him, he wrote a big piece that he didn't himself premiere. In fact, it wasn't premiered for 3 years after its composition. And it also had no reference to anything extra musical. There was no hint of a program in the title. The title Sonata seems by design to foreclose any idea of a program in inheriting kind of the tradition of that term from Beethoven and Mozart. Sonata is literally something that sounds, which doesn't give us much of an idea of a program. There are also a set of rules that sonatas are meant to follow. And in this sonata, Liszt takes all of these rules and invents almost a new sonata form. I won't get into all the details of what he does, but just as a way of orienting you to what you will hear, the very first minute is as close to a table of contents as anything I've ever played or heard. Liszt lays out three motives, short little themes, that then provide the fabric for an astonishing amount of the half-hour piece. There are two other major subjects that occur about 3 minutes in. You'll hear a big arrival in D major, which is the expected key for a second theme area if you're in B minor. That is an important subject. You'll hear that with a lot of very loud chords repeated. It'll sound like a real arrival. And then about a third of the way through, there is a moment where everything kind of stops and we go to the remote key of F sharp major, which is pretty far removed from the keys that we've been in so far. And the tempo changes and everything is very slow. It almost sounds like an organ chorale. And that moment is the last new subject, which then appears later in the piece. So between that table of contents page and then these two other points, it's virtually 100% of the sonata, which has a lot of notes, are covered by these five things. It's hard to hear all of that at first. What I will say is that there have been numerous attempts at defining what the program might have been. Liszt, when asked, was silent. He would not divulge any program. But it does seem like the music is ripe for some kind of interpretation of at least a journey from point A to point B, which is what any sonata from Haydn's time on tries to encapsulate in abstract terms. And I would encourage you to listen for these formal points where material returns and imagine how this music is taking you in a personal way from that point A to point B. And just a tiny spoiler alert, you may find that point B is shockingly similar to point A, but we've had half an hour of this experience together between those two moments.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.